If someone told you Canva is not free, you're free to send them to me and I'll politely correct them. I made this video to show you how much you can actually do on a Canva free account and how to squeeze as much as you can from it. And believe me, there's a lot. I'm Natalia and I help you create better content and grow on social media. So let's do this. Starting off strong, you actually have access to all the design types that Canva offers. I don't think people actually realize how much you can actually do in Canva in that regard. We have a whole range of different files that we can play around with, and all of them are free to use for everyone. The main categories include, of course, social media with all the different posts and video types you can literally think of across all the different platforms, sheets for all your spreadsheet needs like content calendars, trackers, accounting, etc., docs, which are brilliant both for internal documentation and creating lead magnets or products that you can sell. You have presentations, whiteboards, print materials, video formats, and so much miscellaneous stuff like wedding invitations, comic strips, photo collages, album covers, name tags, conference posters. Like, there's so much, and don't let anybody tell you that there aren't free templates available for all of those. Now, I think it's also a good time to mention that you can sell things that you create with a free account. I've seen people say it online and even had questions from you guys in my own DMs on Instagram that someone told you it's not actually possible to sell stuff when you don't have Pro. Well, it's wrong. I highly recommend you check out the licensing agreement as well as this very helpful video from Canva itself explaining what you can and cannot do. The most important thing is that you need to create unique designs by combining elements and can't really resell existing templates or elements on a standalone basis. But if you're planning on selling an ebook, designing a graphic to sell on your merch, using the stuff from the library, again, to create something unique, by all means, you're allowed to sell it. And as always, I'm not a lawyer, it's not legal advice, so make sure you read through the terms yourself. But people have been selling things created on Canva since its inception without the use of Pro account. By the way, if you want to finally master Canva for social media and business, then sign up on WAITLIST for my upcoming Canva course. The other thing that makes Canva so brilliant, not just for free users, but also the paying ones, is its enormous library. It has photos, graphics, animated stickers, videos, audio, charts, frames, grids, mockups, should I really go on. Now, I'll be completely honest and transparent here. There is no way to filter out Pro content for free users, which makes things a lot harder. I know this is a pain point for a lot of free Canva users, but there are still millions of assets available in the Elements tab that are free to all users. Granted, it is trickier to find them because you do have to scroll, but nonetheless, they are there and in droves. Now, as a tip, I recommend starring your favorite creator, your favorite template, element, and then keep building a mini library of free assets from the Elements tab that work for your brand and you can reuse in the future. In fact, I have a video coming up with my best tips to make the free Canva experience so much more effortless with some useful workarounds and more tips like this one, which I'll pin right here once it's published. And of course, subscribe with the notification bell, which is the simplest way to catch it the moment it's out. Bottom line is, there are enough elements and fonts in the library to be able to create beautiful designs without paying a dime. Case in point, add another. And another, and same goes for the templates. Again, there are plenty. You just have to spend a little more time at the beginning by saving your favorites and then building a bank of your own. But hey, I'm already hearing voices coming from the distance saying, but the features are behind a paywall. I can't resize, I can't remove a background, I can't use AI. And sure, fair, there's a lot of goodness available in Canva Pro. And listen, this is why Canva Pro is such a fantastic subscription. If you want to try it for free, there's always a link for you down in the description, but that doesn't mean that the free account is useless and there are no brilliant features. One thing that people never believe me when I say, automatic captions are available in Canva free, and what's more, with karaoke style animations too. So you can literally record some clips, bring them to Canva, trim and edit for free, then add captions for free with text effects and animations for free, and you just got yourself a reel that, again, you didn't have to pay for. Let me highlight some other really great features for you here, but this literally kind of makes me feel like I have to create another video just for the free features alone. Let me know in the comments if this is something that you'd like to see so that I know if there's even interest. But something that you can do is to actually record things in Canva for free. There's a mini recording studio hidden in the uploads that not a lot of people are aware of, and it lets you record lessons for your course, record presentations, and even a voiceover for your social videos. Another free Canva feature lets you present live with notes, all of which won't be seen by your audience. I literally use it all the time when doing trainings or meetings online. It's such a useful tool, and I'm sure you'll love it too. You can collaborate for free. You can use design styles, apply colors. There's literally so much. Let me know if you actually want that video. It might be a good one. Oh, and you also have access to the apps marketplace where you'll find over 600 apps, many of them so helpful and super functional. I've actually recently shared a video on some of my favorites, and you guessed it, they are free. In terms of the limitations, I think the biggest issue is what I've mentioned. So filtering, which means loads of scrolling. As a pro user, you're able to select a filter for free elements, but there's no filtering option for free users. So it would be fantastic to be able to filter out elements that are not accessible, unless you pay for them, of course, but it's only natural that Canva will want to expose you to all of the different options, not just the limited library. The second one, which is what makes Pro such a great subscription, are the crucial functional AI features. So Magic Grab for grabbing subjects from an image and automatically filling the background, which I use all the time for thumbnails, for carousels, for reels, etc. And there's, of course, the iconic background remover. Where would I be without it? There's Magic Expand, which I use almost daily to expand backgrounds from horizontal images or give myself more space in a design. These are all fantastic, very useful, and time-saving features, but don't think that without those, you can't design at all. Don't believe me? Let's jump to Canva and I'll quickly pull something together for you. Okay, so I'm in the Canva editor. I've got the Instagram post size opened in here. And as you can see from the side panel, you actually have quite a few options in the templates library. So there are free templates available to you at all times. Of course, in between, as I've mentioned, you will find different pro elements as well. Now, one of the best things about Canva is the fact that you don't have to start from scratch. So what I can do is to just click on this little recently used template that I found that is actually a free template. And I absolutely love the fact it's quite easily editable. Now, let's go ahead and say new ebook. And just like this, from here at the top, I can go to the fonts, to the text. So again, there are some limitations in terms of the different fonts in here, but you can see that there are quite a lot that are completely free and are really great to use. Now, let's try this one. I really like this font in here. So let me just make it a little smaller, just like that, new ebook. And actually, I like the positioning of it. I might actually just move it ever so slightly to the left just to give it a little bit more space. And I want to just limit the line spacing. This is also available to you like this. So I'll just make it a little tighter and just like that, and maybe make this one a little smaller just to introduce a little bit more hierarchy to this whole thing. Now you can see that these are actually different frames for mockups. So one way to find it is to go and find mockup like this at the top. And you can see loads of different graphics that if you wanted to swap the tablets to phones, for example, you would be able to very easily do it. So this is how easy it is to add them. You can use your uploads to load your own images, or you can actually just go to elements and find different kind of stylish photos in here. So let's look for stylish. Let's see what I can find in here just to find some cool photos. And of course, you see quite a few different pro ones, but there are actually really beautiful ones like this one, for example, as a free option. And of course, I want more of what it came from. So I'll just push it to the side and make it a little smaller, maybe then a little bigger like this. Another great feature that's available in the Canva toolkit is the corner rounding, because it's something that we want to kind of hide underneath this frame. So let me move it ever so slightly. And this is how easily it was to just pack this image underneath our first frame, just like this. I might actually go ahead and delete this one. You could see that that other one was actually a frame. I'll group these two together because it's another great option that we've got available. And you can just move it ever so slightly. But as I've mentioned, I want more from where that came from. I can just easily duplicate this element by holding Alt like this, or you can just copy it by going Control C and Control V in a very classic way. Now we have another one. I'll ungroup this one because I actually want the second one to look a little differently. Now, this one, I can just right click on any image that I've got and go to info. And from here, you can view more by this particular creator. You'll see all the different photos. This is actually an aggregate of different photos, so this core lens, but I can go to info again and you can see that this actual image is a part of the collection. More often than not, if you find something that is free, you can actually go to that collection and you'll see that all the other images in that collection are usually free. So this is really great because this allows you to have that cohesive look without searching too much in the library once you find something that you really love. Let's go ahead for this really fun photo. I'll just add it in here and let me just drag it on top just to make sure that it looks exactly the same, just like this. I'll just stretch it out and make it a little smaller, just like that. And I'll have to just, of course, make it fit the screen. So I'll go ahead like this. Another great option is to go to copy style and then apply it in here. And this will make sure that it's applying the exact same corner rounding that I've applied before. So I can just stack them two together, select the one below me, I'll remove it, and then send it to back. And just like that, we have our second element. Of course, now things are becoming to look a little differently, but I will still remove the frame from underneath. And you can see that this shadow was retained and it's just behind it as well. I might actually tuck it in a little bit more because it's quite a big shadow, but I think it still looks pretty cool in here. So the one that we've got left is, of course, our third one, just like this. I'll retain this particular one in here and I'll just drag this element again. I'll go back to the rotation. Let's ungroup it. Just like this, send this one to the back. You can see that I'm constantly using shortcuts. This is what really makes your designing much faster. So I highly recommend you actually watch this video, which will give you all the different tips to become more proficient and much quicker at designing in Canva. This is a very short demonstration. I just want to breeze through it and show you what you are actually capable of doing. I have plenty of different tutorials on my channel, so you can watch them later on to get familiarized with Canva a lot more. Maybe let's go for this one. Let's go full on bold. This is quite a cool photo. Again, I'll apply the style like this just to retain that corner rounding, just like this, and I'll just stretch it out like that. And of course, you can see now that it's cutting a bit of the eyeglasses, so I'll just move it around to center it. This is how you very easily just crop things. I've just sent it to the back and I'll remove the front one from here. Go ahead, group these two together and then rotate like this. And now, based on another template that we've had before, we actually created something a little different. This is something that I really love. You can see that from here, you can, of course, change the text as you wish. You can change the positioning of any of the elements that you like. I might actually make it a little bolder. From here, you can also go to the color panel. And maybe if I wanted to, you know, make a little bit more of that kind of fun color that we've had from the photo shine through in here, I can add it in here. Another great thing is the effects tab, of course. So from here, you've got the option to splice. So maybe in the splice, I could go ahead and choose the color like this. So you have a color picker. I could go ahead and choose this lovely red in here. And already we're making the whole thing a lot more cohesive. I can add a thickness to it to add a bit more character to it. I can offset it like this if I want to. I can change direction just like that to make it look just the way I like it. And like this, you have some fun text, again, on a completely free Canva account. I'll go back to the non-text version, but I just wanted to show you the effects and what they can actually do. And I can reposition it and, of course, change the text, do whatever you like to do. From other elements, you could go ahead and choose any of the graphics from here and overlay. How about we try a texture, actually? So let's go for a texture and let's see what we can find in the graphics. In the graphics, will I find something that I like? Let's go for maybe grainy. See, this is the way you're trying to kind of find different things and different textures that might work for the character of the whole thing. I actually like a lot the fact that my template kind of matched the colors from the wall behind in here. So I could go ahead and maybe add it like this. And I will actually flip it from the top horizontally. And you can already see that the character in here is completely changed. Let's try to find something a little more funky. Maybe this one in here is quite a cool element to add a little bit of that kind of visual interest, just like that. I could add it to the back like this and then maybe rotate it and make it a little smaller, just like that. Ooh, and then add these elements. It's already kind of coming together and looking completely different to what we had in the original. So you can see that already we have something completely different to what we had initially. Of course, you can change the fonts in here. You can change the colors as well. So this is quite a very fast way of showing you that even on free, you can create fun designs and you don't always have to start from scratch. You can just get inspired by whatever you find here in the templates tab. If you find one that you like, you can go and see the suggested ones. So once you click on it, it will open the different ones from kind of the same style or using the same vibe. So try to search for something that you really love and then make sure you retain it and keep practicing, keep designing. This is how you find your flair within Canva. Now, make sure to watch this video to learn Canva basics for beginners on a free account and check out the best free apps at the moment. Like this video if you enjoyed it. It helps me bring more free education to you and subscribe so that you don't miss the next Canva free videos I'm dropping very soon. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next time.